Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti Access Starter Kit, so the UA-SK. It's not going to be a big technical overview, but probably going to need to give you a little bit of a concept idea to help you through with this product. Ubiquiti Access, all right, and in this instance, this is the actual controller portion, the physical controller portion. Ubiquiti Access is a door access system. The idea being that it can open or unlock electronic door locks, and you can control the access with an access card. So there are a few things to note about this. You need one of these for each door that you uniquely need to be able to control. So let me say that you uniquely need to be able to control. So this is the main hub unit. This is PoE powered. All right, you have, I'll show you this fully in a minute, but you're going to basically wire your electric door into this. All right, so you will need, it will provide the power for that. It'll be a 12 volt power generally to your mag lock. All right, you can power some other devices across the top, which we'll have a look at in a moment. And then the idea is either somebody will come up to the door and push their card against one of these readers. All right, and that will send the unlock signal to this door. It controls only this one unit. So one reader, all right, essentially one unit. There are different ways that people have done this. I've seen multiple people connect multiple doors to this, but when that one card is put against that one reader, it unlocks all of the doors that are physically connected to this. So if you want one card to be able to unlock multiple doors, then this is gonna work for you. Just for one unit, but generally you're going to have one of these on each door that you need to uniquely control. All right, so let me walk you through what you're going to get in the box. So you're going to get the actual unit itself, which we'll have a look at in a moment. You are going to get a small piece of metal here to allow you to fit that to the wall, which we'll have a look at in a moment. All right, you are then going to get a pack here of NFC cards. Let me just open this up. Here's the pack for you. All right, each one of these then can be uniquely, let's check we've got this up there, each one of these can be uniquely programmed for the user so that they can obviously touch that against the reader and gain access to your facility. You are then going to get a standard card reader. Now again, you can connect a number of these, so let me just hold that up so you can have a look there. You can see on the back here, we've got an RJ45 connection. This is PoE powered. There are a number of PoE ports on the top here. So generally you'd have one of these readers, and I'll have a look at the other bit. You can, might have the Pro, you might have two of these. You might have one of these on the outside, and you might have a push button exit on the inside that when you push it again, sends the request to unlock the door. All right, so let me just hold that up. You can see again that you've got your little reset button at the back. All right, so that's the UA reader. So you can buy all these components separately. So that's the UA reader. What you then get in a little box is the ability to mount that. You've got some cutouts. You've got the little front cover there for it. Hopefully you can see that. And then if we lift this out of the box here, you can see all of the different screw fittings we have to be able to fit that to the wall. So obviously the idea would be, let me show you the extra piece that you get. So you get that for the fitting. All right, and then here you get a number of fitting options. Let me take these all out of here. Take these out of here carefully out of the piece of card. Here we go. All right, so obviously you're going to have your as you can see, you're going to need a cutout there into your wall. You've got a number of options. You have a faceplate here and a back plate. So we can obviously fix that to the wall. Gives us our shaping here. Allows our unit then to plug in to that. So you probably won't be quite flat wall because you're going to need some dig out for the RJ45 in the back. But that allows you to obviously mount it. Then you do have some extra covers, like we said, of quick ways of being able to mount these into place again if you want to. Whoops. If you want to there. Sorry, this one puts just a basic shield that you could have screwed onto a piece of wood and then pushed this in. So you need one of these readers. Like I said, this is the UA reader. You can buy those separately. So that's for card access. You then have a similar with the UA Reader Pro. This has a small screen on it, color screen. Ubiquiti several years ago brought out a wearable camera that their CEO developed. Never really quite took off. That's what this is now being turned into. All right, so you have a camera at the top here, you have a screen at the bottom. This works very much similar to the doorbell features. You can long push, I think it is, or swipe to push and use this as a doorbell indicator. So let me have a little look on there. Again, side profile, and you can see at the back there, it has an RJ45 connection. So you can use this if you want to have a talk facility to somebody. And use it a little bit more like a doorbell. You then get another one of the actual brackets here in the box to mount this in place. So again, this would fit directly in there. Hopefully you can see that this would fit directly in there to hold it. All right, and you get a set of backing plates in this box as well, in the same way as we saw for the UA Reader. All right, so we've got our plate here. All right, that can be mounted on the wall. Obviously, you're going to have a little bit of a dig out behind or a dugout behind. You have then got your face plate here. All right, and then your unit can go all the way through that. Sorry, separate those two pieces out. It can go into this, fitted into this back plate there, clipped, or you can just clip this straight into place. Probably the wrong way up, that way up, I think it is. So actually it holds into place and that will go outside at your door. All right, so we've got all of those bits. Now we have to have a look at the unit itself. All right, so just show you the back there. We've got this spring release mechanism here. The idea that we can actually clip this into a bracket that we can mount, I think, into the wall and then clip this into place, all right, but still be able to release it later on. So you can see the entry hook there to hold it in place. All right, so let me show you then front up here. Let me see if I can hold that so you can see the full front there. Hopefully it's not glared too much. You have a large number of inputs here and options. You've got 12 volt out, you've got non-12 volt, you've got other wiring pins here. This is really probably comes down to a concept of your electrical understanding and wiring that you can do. So you can have push bar at exit points that don't need the card reader, but still, I think, close a circuit. And when it closes the circuit, it will then activate the door unlocking push button on the inside. You could wire this to multiple doors to make it work so that when one connection is made, then it can then unlock multiple doors. So there's quite a lot you can do, but really this is your controller unit. Beyond how you make that work, we'll need some level of understanding of how an electronic door system or control system works. Anyway, all right, now this is PoE powered, PoE++, so 802.3BT, I think it needs, so make sure you've got a PoE++ switch, or you can use a high-powered PoE injector to control this. So your power in is on this side here, and then we've got three PoE ports across the top. There, obviously you need one for your reader. If you've just got one reader and you're maybe just going to use a mechanical push button on the inside, leaves you with two other PoE ports on there, which you could then use to put two cameras connected to it. So this can work slightly like a hub. So you can obviously still then view the content from those cameras, because this is obviously going to be closer to your door. So you do get now you get PoE closer to your door, all right? But you can't have multiple of these, like if you like, chained together. They don't control multiple of these. So you need a cable for each one of your doors running PoE++ that's then gonna control these three ports. You can do stuff on here. People have done various scripts of bits and pieces with cameras connected and sending unlocks. I would probably use the UA Reader Pro here so that you can use it more like a doorbell. And just a few extra little bits on this. This doesn't work in the same way as UniFi Protect, so it doesn't integrate with UniFi Protect. It is a completely separate app. There isn't like a sounder or a doorbell chime that you can get for this currently. So just be aware of that. This operates in its own setup. You will need a cloud key or an OS console-based supported products. So we've got the CloudKey Gen 2 Plus. You can run this on the UDR, UDM Pro, UDM SE. Those are your key ones, all right? You have a completely separate control panel that allows you to manage all of this. So hopefully that's been useful. There's quite a lot of information there. You probably do research some of the Ubiquiti forums to give you everything that you need. But this is the Ubiquiti UA-SK, the Ubiquiti Access Starter Kit, where you get this. You get a pack of cards that go with it. You get the reader there. That you get, and you get the Reader Pro and all the fitments, so enough really to start it what you want. So I do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got loads more box openings on wireless firewalls and networking devices, plenty on how-to guides, how to set up UniFi Protect, how to set up UniFi Network, and how to even secure your networks for firewalls. So do stay subscribed, and I hope to see you again soon.